You are about to listen to Where Is Your Altar? By Gabriel Agbo. Copyright Gabriel Agbo 2020. Narrated by Ian A. Miller and distributed by Tech Time. Introduction. An altar is a place of sacrifice. It is a place of worship. It is where the humans and the spirits meet regularly. Altars demand for sacrifice, and sacrifices attract God. If you want to have a very cordial relationship with God, you must establish an altar and maintain it regularly with sacrifice. And I take it for granted that you know that today's sacrifice is no more the animals, birds, candles, incense, grains or burnt offerings, etc., but our lives dedicated to God. It is the holiness, dedication, praise, prayer, worship, meditations, and service we give to the Almighty. Today we offer sweet-smelling, pleasing sacrifice to Him by living a holy and dedicated life. The life we live ascends to Him as a sweet-smelling savor, as a pleasing odor. Now, I ask, are you living as a sacrifice to Him? Do you have an altar? Do you have for your family? Where do you pray? Do you have a dedicated place and time for it? Do you give Him enough praise and worship? Do you know that heaven comes to wait for you at your regular time and place of worship? Are you an altar to Him? Yes, He wants us to be mobile altars. And what of the heathen, the occult, the Satanists? Do they have their own altars? Can they affect us? This is an interesting book. Dedication. I dedicate this book to Chanel Brown from Jamaica. Thank you for all you are doing for the Lord and His people. May God bless you. Amen. Chapter 1. Where is your altar? An altar is a place where humans regularly sacrifice and relate to the spirits, the supernatural. Like we have already said in the introduction, you must have a functional altar, or at best, be an altar for God to have a cordial relationship with Him. If you want to have all His blessings, if you want to be spiritual, powerful, and move in the supernatural, you must establish an altar and regularly maintain it. Now, the earliest we find altar in the Bible is in the story of deluge. The first thing that Noah did as he was disembarking from the ark after the flood was to build an altar and sacrifice to God. Note that the Bible also said that he selected the animals and birds approved for that purpose, that is, according to specifications. It is not just enough to serve God, but you must serve Him the way He wants. And what was the result? God was so pleased that He immediately began to speak to Noah. God cannot resist a proper sacrifice made on a holy altar. This is just what I have discovered from the scriptures and from my personal experiences. Once the altar is right and sacrifice is according to specification, He will come down to accept it. Listen to this. Then Noah built an altar to the Lord, and there he sacrificed as burnt offerings the animals and birds that had been approved for that purpose. And the Lord was pleased with the aroma of the sacrifice, and said to Himself, I will never again curse the ground because of the human race, even though everything they think or imagine is bent toward evil from childhood. I will never again destroy all living things. As long as the earth remains, there will be planting and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night. Genesis 8, verses 20 through 22. I love the way other translations put it. NIV said that the Lord smelled the pleasing aroma. KJV said that the Lord smelled a sweet savor. Good News said the odor of the sacrifice pleased the Lord. So our sacrifice, prayers, and worship do ascend to God as sweet-smelling savor, as a pleasing aroma. This is wonderful. Noah's sacrifice pleased God so much. It was like a well-prepared delicacy, and it forced Him to come down. You need an altar and a worthy sacrifice if you really want to have a good and regular relationship with God. You need an altar if you want to stop those things that want to stop you. You need it if you want to break those generational curses around your family, remove that sickness, and break that circle of failure and pain. Altars and sacrifices are indeed very powerful. Noah built one, sacrificed on it, and forced God to start an indiscriminate release of blessings and covenants. Altars will attract sacrifices, and sacrifices will instigate divine covenants and blessings. This order does not fail. Yes, show me a man that has an altar, and I will show you him that God cannot afford to disappoint. Now, we have already mentioned that in this dispensation we no longer require the animals and the birds, incense and burnt offerings as sacrifice on the altar, but to fully dedicate our life to God. Our life, obedience, and service to Him are now the sacrifices. Yes, it is very important to state this from the beginning so that some will not be carried away. Maybe we will glance through that before we continue, shall we? And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all He has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind He will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship Him. Don't copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. Romans 12, verse 1. You heard that? We are now the living sacrifices to God. Jesus Christ has ended the old order of sacrificing animals and opened the new of believing in Him. Today we offer sweet-smelling, pleasing sacrifice to Him by living a holy and dedicated life. The life we live ascends to Him as a sweet-smelling savor, as a pleasing odor. Now, I ask, are you living as a sacrifice to Him, holy and dedicated? Do you have an altar for your family? Where do you pray? Do you have a dedicated place and time for it? Do you give Him enough praise and worship? Do you know that heaven comes to wait for you at your regular time and place of worship? I remember our prayer team in Port Harcourt. We prayed and worshipped God every night in the church, that we practically turned the place into an altar for Him. The divine traffic became heavy and evident because He was always in our midst. And this you will know through divine manifestations, visitations, healing, deliverances, visions, and miracles. We always felt the presence of God mightily. Every day from 10 p.m. to 3 a.m., we sang, praised, worshipped, and prayed on the Scriptures. When you pray and worship, you attract heaven, and when you do it regularly at a place you raise an altar and turn the activities into a sacrifice, you will force God to dwell there or at least visit regularly. He loves praise and worship so much that's His food. Now, where is your altar? Set up one today and begin to maintain it, and you will see and hear those things which you have not known before. True. Most of us do not have where we meet with God, a regular place of prayer and worship, a place where you go to offer Him sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. You spend your time foolishly at worldly places, in clubs and bars, unedifying visits, gossiping, ungodly companies, watching films, reading ungodly material, watching television, etc. You don't have time for God and His Word, and you expect His presence to be with you. You are joking. The more time you spend with Him, the more anointing and His presence that you will carry. It is that simple. Show me a person that spends quality time with God, and I will show you a person who is filled with His presence and power. God wants to be with you. He wants to bless you. He wants to fill you with His Spirit, power, and grace. But you must first make an altar for Him and also spend quality time there. You must be able to spend at least 2 or 3 hours in His presence every day, reading the Bible, worshiping, meditating, and praying to Him. I hope you heard me well. There are so many things, secrets, that God will want to share with you. But that will not be possible until you begin to create time for Him. All the people that did exploit for God were men and women of altars.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.